Hi everyone, let's learn about least recently used page replacement algorithm now. So previously, in my previous video, I told you about first in first out page replacement and then about optimal page replacement. So to recap, page replacement is nothing but whenever we all know that pages of a process will be residing on the disk, and whenever a page has to be brought from the disk to the memory, whenever a page is required for execution by the CPU, and when that page is not residing in the memory, then a page fault is said to occur. And whenever a page fault occurs, the job of the page replacement algorithm is to check whether and if there are no free frames in the computer's memory to bring the page from the disk to the memory, then the page replacement algorithm checks which frame can be emptied, which page can be moved from the currently existing frame in the memory to the disk, and so that it can load the desired page from the disk to the main memory. So what happens is you have a CPU, you have the primary memory, you have the secondary memory. All the pages of a process will be residing on the secondary memory. Whenever required, they are going to be brought into the primary memory. So in the meantime, if CPU tries to access some instruction from the primary memory, and let's say at that time, if that instruction is not in the primary memory but in the disk, CPU will not be able to execute it, and this creates something called as a page fault. Whenever a page fault occurs, the job of the page replacement algorithm is to find a victim frame, and whenever a page fault occurs and when there is no space in the memory to bring the needed page from the disk to the main memory, then a page replacement algorithm selects one victim frame. Victim frame is nothing but out of all the full frames, one frame is selected, and that page in the frame is moved to the secondary memory, and the desired page is brought from the secondary memory to the primary memory. I hope you are able to visualize the concept. So that is what I have told in the solved problem in the video also, in the FIFO page replacement algorithm video. So in FIFO, we will take the oldest page. The page which is selected for replacement will be the oldest page in the memory. In optimal page replacement algorithm, we will see the future page references, and whichever page is going to be referenced last, that will be selected for replacement. The third type of page replacement algorithm is your least recently used page replacement algorithm. Listen to it carefully, because as I told you, you will get problems in this. In optimal page replacement algorithm, we will see the future page references, but in least recently used page replacement algorithm, we will see the past page references. Whenever a page or a frame has to be selected for replacement, the page replacement algorithm will see the past page references and see the strategy which is used by every page replacement algorithm. This is very important to remember and understand. This least recently used, that is called in short as LRU, LRU page replacement algorithm selects the page which has not been used for the longest period of time. Has not been used means it refers to past page reference. See the past page references. Whichever is coming last, that is the page which has not been used for the longest period of time. That page will be selected for replacement. Okay, so here if you have to implement this algorithm, then you have to know the time of last use of each page. You have to use some data structure to monitor the time of last use of each page, and by the value in the data structure, you have to find out which page is least used. Whichever page is having the smallest time of use value, that will be the page which is least used and will be selected for replacement. Now let's go into the problem. Please listen, please look at the slide carefully. See, this is your reference string. Reference string is nothing but it denotes the set of all page numbers. Whatever numbers here denotes the page numbers containing the instructions which are referenced by the CPU. Okay, so initially the problem starts with all empty frames. We have been initially given with three empty frames, and so because we are following some form of pure demand paging, so no page is loaded into memory initially. First page reference is 7. So this generates a page fault. Wherever there is a page fault, I have marked with this one. If this is there, that means page fault has occurred. If this is not there in front of a page reference, that means there is no page fault for that reference. Okay. So first page reference is page number 7. So page number 7 is currently all frames are initially all frames are empty. So this generates a page fault, and 7 is loaded into memory. Next page reference is 0. 0 is also, see this one, 0 is not there in the memory. So this generates a page fault and then 0 is loaded into memory. After loading 0, memory looks like this. Next page reference is page number 1. 1 is not there in the memory. See this one. After loading 0 and before loading 1, memory looks like this. 1 is not there in memory, so it generates a page fault. When it generates a page fault, and then your 1 will be loaded from the disk into the memory, and then it looks like this. Okay, so now when we loaded 1, we are left with 3 page faults. Next page reference is 2. Now comes the role of our LRU page replacement algorithm. In LRU page replacement algorithm, the page which has not been used for the longest period of time will be replaced. Has not been used means you have to see the past page references. Page reference is two pages which are there in memory, 7, 0 and 1. See when it is referenced previously. 1, 0, 7. 7 comes last. In the past page references, 7 comes last. It means 7 has not been used for the longest period of time. So replace 7 with 2. Okay. Next page reference is 0. 0 is already there in the memory, so there is no page fault. If a page is there in memory, no page fault. If a page is not there in memory, it generates a page fault. Next page reference is page number 3. So 3 is not there in memory, so it generates a page fault. Then now 3 has to be loaded, but there is no space in the memory. So one of the pages has to be replaced. 2, 0 and 1. Check when it is appearing. 0, 2, 1. 1 appears last, which means 1 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 1 will be replaced with 3. Okay. The next page reference is 0. So 0 is already there in memory, so it doesn't generate a page fault. Next page reference is page number 4. Page number 4 is not there in memory, so it generates a page fault. And then what is there in memory? 2, 0 and 3. Check out the previous page references. 0, 3, 2. 2 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 2 will be replaced with 4. Okay, 4, 0 and 3. Next page reference is 2. 2 is not there in memory here. So in memory we have 4, 0 and 3. Check out 4, 0 and 3. 3 is not being used for the longest period of time. So 3 will be replaced with 2. Okay. Next page reference is 3. 3 is not there in memory. So we have to replace either 4 or 0 or 2. Check out the past page reference. 2, 4, 0. So 0 will be replaced with 3. Next page reference is 0. Again, 4, 3 and 2 is there in memory. So it generates a page fault. And we have to replace one of the frames. What are there? 4, 3 and 2. So 3, 2, 4. 4 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 4 will be replaced with 0. Okay. Next, 3 occurs. 3 is already there in memory, so it doesn't generate any page fault. Next page reference is 2. 2 is also already there in memory, so it doesn't generate a page fault. Next page reference is 1. Now 1 is not there in memory, so it generates a page fault. And then you have to replace either 0 or 3 or 2. See here, 2, 3, 0. 0 is referenced last. 0 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 0 is replaced with 1. Okay. Next page reference is 2. 2 is already there in memory, so it doesn't generate a page fault. Next page reference is 0. 0 is not there in memory. You have only 1, 3 and 2. So see the past page reference, you have 2, 1 and 3. 3 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 3 is replaced with 0 in the second frame. Next page reference is 1. 1 is already there in memory, so there is no page fault occurring. Next page reference is 7. 7 is not there in memory, so it generates a page fault. and we have to replace either 1 or 0 or 2. So 1, 0, 2. 2 occurs last in the past page reference, which means 2 has not been used for the longest period of time. So 2 is replaced with 7. Okay. Next page reference is 0. 0 is already there in memory, so it does not generate any page fault. Next page reference is 1. 1 is also already there in memory, so it does not generate any page fault. So this is the set of page faults generated for this algorithm, and with this we come to the end of the reference string. How many page faults are generated? We have 12 page faults generated. We have worked out the same problem for FIFO with the same reference string for FIFO page replacement algorithm, and we got 15 page faults. So with this you can understand that LRU page replacement algorithm is far better than FIFO algorithm, but it is worse than optimal replacement algorithm. But if you had gone through that video, I would have told that it is almost impossible or very, very difficult to implement optimal page replacement algorithm, because there we will be seeing future page references, and predicting future page references is almost impossible task and or a very difficult task. So even though it is worse than optimal, it is not possible to implement practically optimal page replacement algorithm. So this least recently used algorithm is considered to be a good algorithm, and it's also a frequently used algorithm. I would recommend that I will be posting this video in the classroom. So what you can do is you write it down in your notebook and do it once again for yourself. I agree that nothing will be equal to that of straight away standing in front of you and explaining, or explaining sitting next to you and explaining this on a notebook. But then now this is the only option available to us. Either we should have online classes or through recorded videos only, I'll be able to explain you. So you take a notebook, write down this reference string, write down the frames, try doing it once for yourself. Then you will try to understand and come to know where you will get stuck. There is no need for getting stuck here, because just understand one thing: whenever a page has to be replaced, see what page references are here and check out where it occurs in the past. See which page number occurs last. That will be the page number which has not been referenced for the longest period of time. Replace that page. It will come with practice. Try doing it once in your notebook. Then it will be easier for you to solve the practice problems. So next algorithm is your LRU. So next is your implementation of this LRU algorithm. So we have seen what is LRU algorithm. We have to see the past page references. So if you have to see the past page references, you can implement it by using a counter or by using a stack. If you have to implement using a counter, what you can do is, we know that page table means it will contain page number and frame number, right? Along with that, you can also add one more entry called time of use field. And we can have a logical clock or a counter attached with the CPU. Whenever the CPU references a page, the logical clock or counter can be incremented, and the value in the logical counter of the CPU will be copied to the time of use field. In this way, if a page is referenced more frequently, its time of use field will be large. If a page is used less frequently, it will have a smaller value for the time of use field. So when a page has to be selected for replacement, a page which has the smallest time of use value can be selected for replacement. So this is the strategy behind that. But the disadvantage here is, we are going to maintain this time of use field in the page table. And page table resides in the computer's memory. So every time we need to update the value of time of use field, we have to search the page table, and it needs one memory access. And memory access is a very time consuming task, and it will also slow down the CPU execution. So that is one disadvantage. The second method of implementation is by using a stack. So here we maintain a stack like this. So this is how this example is given in the book. They have told that at a particular point of time, when 2 is being referenced, stack looks like this, and when 7 is being referenced, stack looks like this. But for your better understanding, I have just written the elements of the stack when all these other numbers or page numbers are being referenced. Then only you will come to know how at this point you came into this values. Okay, let's say you will have a stack like this in the stack based implementation. And what this implementation will do is, whenever a page is referenced, it will be moved to the top of the stack. Okay, regardless of wherever it is, it will be removed from the position in the stack even from the middle of the stack or somewhere, and it will be moved to the top of the stack. And so in this manner, most recently used page will always be in the top of the stack, and the least recently used page will always be in the bottom of the stack. See here, first page reference is page number 4. So page number 4 will be on the top of the stack. Next page reference is page number 7. 4 is pushed down and 7 occupies the top of the stack. Next page reference is page number 0. 7 and 4 is pushed down and 0 occupies the top of the stack. Next page reference is page number 7. Now you have 7. 7 is moved to the top of the stack and 0 and 4 is pushed to the bottom of the stack. Next page reference is 1. 1 is just occupies the top of the stack and 7, 0, 4 will be pushed down to the bottom. Next page reference is 0. 0 is there, but it is moved to the top of the stack, and as such, remaining elements will be pushed down. 1, 7 and 4 will be pushed down. Next you have 1. So you already have 1 here, but it will be removed from the middle and it will be pushed to the top of the stack, and 0 will be pushed to the bottom of the stack. Okay, then you have 2. 2 is not there in the stack, so 2 will be moved to the top of the stack, and then you have 1, 0, 7 and 4. Next you have 1. You have 1, but this will be moved to the top of the stack and 2 will be pushed to the bottom of the stack. So next you have, below 1 you will have 2, 0, 7 and 4. Next you get 2. So 2 is there, it will be moved to the top of the stack and you will get 1, 0, 7 and 4 below it. Next page reference is 7. You already have 7, but the 7 will be removed from the middle and it will be moved to the top. And all other elements will be just pushed to one position below. 2, 1, 0 and 4. So you have 2, 1, 0 and 4. So this is how the stack looks like at different points of page references. So when you use a stack to record the most recent page references, the top of the stack will always contain the most recent page references and the bottom of the stack will contain the least recently used page. So getting the least recently used page is very easy in this stack method, but updation operation, whenever a page is accessed, you will have to remove it from even the middle of the stack and you'll have to push it to the top of the stack. For this, we'll be making use of a doubly linked list with two pointers, with head and tail pointers, to appropriately change the position of the elements. So this is going to be an expensive task. That is the disadvantage of this stack-based implementation. The next type of algorithms is LRU approximation algorithms. In the just seen LRU algorithm, it makes use of special hardware, because you have to attach a clock register with the CPU and you have to use the time of use field along with the page table. So all this requires hardware support, but all computer systems don't provide this hardware support. So there you cannot implement LRU. But many of the operating systems provides little bit of support in the form of a reference bit. So initially this reference bit will be associated with all the pages of a process, and whenever a page is referenced by the process, that reference bit will be set to 1. It will be initialized to 0, and if the page is referenced, it's going to be initialized to 1. Like that, with that we will identify when the page is referenced. But the disadvantage is, if reference bit is 1, we will know that the page has been referenced, but we can't know the order of its reference, which is most recently referenced or least recently referenced. But if hardware support is not provided, then we cannot implement the LRU algorithm. We have to manage with whatever is being given by the hardware. So based on this reference bit concept, there are two types of LRU approximation algorithms. If the number of reference bits used is 1, then that algorithm is called a second chance algorithm. And we have another algorithm called as the enhanced second chance algorithm. These two are the LRU approximation algorithms based on the reference bits. Now, what is the second chance algorithm? Second chance algorithm basically works like a first in, first out algorithm. Always remember that. What is first in, first out page replacement algorithm? There, the oldest page, whichever page came first, that will be removed first. Okay. Basic algorithm used here is FIFO, but then it also, to make a decision of page replacement, it will also make use of this reference bit. So how it will replace is, It will check the reference bit. Whenever a page has to be selected for replacement, the OS will check the reference bit. If the reference bit of a particular page is zero, immediately that page will be selected for replacement. But in case, if the reference bit of a particular page is one, then the page will be given a second chance. Okay, reference bit zero means you replace. Reference bit one means you don't replace. You set the reference bit to zero. The OS will set the reference bit of the page to zero and moves to the next page. Here, before doing that, it also sets the arrival time of that page to current time. What does it mean? That page will be replaced only after all other pages in the memory have been given second chance. Only if all other pages whose reference bit is set to one have been changed to reference bit zero and they have been given second chance, then only this page will get its chance to be replaced from the computer's memory. Okay? So that's why it's called second chance algorithm. That you can understand from this diagram. This is also called clock-based page replacement algorithm. Why? Because we use a pointer which resembles a clock hand. That's why it's called clock-based page replacement algorithm. So here this pointer will always be pointing to the page which has to be replaced next. See here, and the set of pages in memory is maintained as a circular queue. Okay, set of all the pages residing in the memory will be maintained using a circular queue, and the reference bit will be associated with each pages in memory. And you have a pointer which will always be pointing to which page is to be replaced next. Let's say pointer is currently pointing to this page. So as I told you, it checks the reference bit of this page. It has to select one page for replacement now. It checks the reference bit. Pointer is pointing here. The reference bit is one. So it gives this page a second chance. It sets the reference bit to zero and moves to the next page. Here also the reference bit is one. It sets the reference bit of this process to zero and moves to the next page. Here the reference bit of this process is zero. So immediately it selects this page for replacement. So this strategy is called second chance page replacement algorithm. So until all these pages, this one, everything is being changed to zero, is being given a second chance, this particular page will not be replaced or moved from the primary memory. So this algorithm is called second chance page replacement algorithm. By that, what we are actually doing, the oldest page is going to be replaced from the memory first. And along with that, we try to give each page a second chance so that we are giving each page a second chance. That means if it is a most frequently used page, it will be in memory by this strategy. That is the reason behind that. The next algorithm is enhanced second chance algorithm. Here, apart from the reference bit, we also use one more bit called modify bit. Why I put if available here is not all hardware provides support for two bits. So if it is provided by the hardware, we use two bits to decide which page to replace. Now, when we use two bits, we have four different combinations of these bits, right? Based on the four different combinations of the reference bit and modify bit, we have four different, we call this as classes. We have four different classes. This first one is the lowest class. Above this is the second one, which is one class above this class. Okay. Next we have third and fourth. Fourth is the highest class. Okay. What is the meaning of class? A page which is in the highest class category will not be selected for replacement first. Always, whenever a page replacement has to be done, we use the clock scheme, but we use the four classes, and we'll always try to replace the page in the lowest class. What do I mean? If I have a page in class number one, I'll try, and if I have a page in class number two also, I'll try to give preference to class number one and try to replace this page only. Similarly, if I have a page in class number two and three, satisfying class number two or satisfying class number three, if I have two pages, the page satisfying class number two will be first replaced. So in this way, priorities in what order priorities are given for processes to be replaced. That is categorized by using this class category. So first 0, 0, what does it mean? Reference bit is also zero and modified bit is also zero. What does it mean? The page has not been recently used and the page has not been modified also. Such a page is the best one for replacement, right? It's not recently used. That means it's a LRU approximation algorithm. So we give preference to the least recently used page for replacing it from the memory. So this is the best page for replacement. Second one is, it's not least recently used, but it would have been modified. When it was used, it would have been modified. So here also, it's not least recently used, right? Even though it was modified, it's not currently being used. So this is also a good page for replacement. But then since it has been modified, all the modified contents have to be updated before being swapping it out to the disk. Next page is, recently used bit is set to 1 and modified bit is set to 0, which means it's been recently used. So again also, there is a chance that it can be used again. But modified bit is set to 0. So there's no need for writing it out. So there is chance for it to be used again. So this page mostly will not be should not be selected for replacement. Fourth one is, both the bits are set to 1. So probably they are getting modified. This page is getting modified now and then, and it's also getting being used also now and then frequently. So this page should be given high priority, and mostly, as far as possible, this set of pages should not be replaced from the memory, because if it is replaced also, it will immediately be needed again. So we should never try to replace pages with both the bits set to 1. So whenever OS has to select a page for replacement, it will give preference based on the class to which the page belongs to. If you have a page if you have three pages whose classes are 1, 2, and 3 respectively, then the page with class number 1 will be selected for replacement first. Or else if you have two pages with classes 2, 3, and 4, then the page with class number 2 will be replaced. Always the lowest category page will be selected for replacement first. That's called as enhanced second chance algorithm, because we make use of one more bit called as a modify bit also to select the page for replacement. The last type of page replacement algorithm is called as counting based page replacement. There are different various ways by which we select a page for replacement. Here, as the name implies, we use a counter to keep track of how many times that page has been referenced. Okay, but this is not frequently used because it's very much expensive to keep track of the counter and maintain the page references. But then it is of two types, least frequently used and most frequently used. So in least frequently used, the page which has not been referenced for the most period of time, that is, whichever page is having that count value less, we select the page for replacement. Obviously, it is not being used. So we think that it's not being used, so it's of no use, so we replace the page. Most frequently used algorithm means, here the page which is used for most part of the time, okay, will be replaced. That means if a page has been referenced 5 times and another page has been referenced only 1 time, then in this algorithm, we will replace the page which is referenced 5 times. What is the concept behind this is, it assumes that if a page is having less count, then probably it is just now it has entered the memory and may be used very soon. That is the concept behind replacing a most frequently used page. If a page has been used most of the time, then it assumes that it will not be used in the future. Most of its use is over, so it may not be used in future. That is the assumption made in this most frequently used algorithm. So with this, we come to the end of chapter 9 and with the end of the concept of page replacement algorithms.